Good morning, dear students. Today we are going to study the next chapter, that is Principles of Management. So far we have studied about management and the introduction about management we have studied. Now we are moving on to the second chapter, that is Principles of Management. Okay, Principles of Management, the concept, meaning of principles of management. The first term that we have to study is about what is principles of management. So we have already studied about principles. What is the meaning of principles? Principles means you have heard about the word principles. There are two principles are there. One is the principle and the another one is the principal. Okay, so principle means the rules and regulations. Okay, so for doing any kind of activity, there are some rules and regulations. So such kind of rules and regulations are called as the principles. Okay, or how activity has to be performed. It gives the guideline to specify about what are the or how a activity has to be performed. Okay, so how the management has to be performed, about that the principles are describing. So that is those kinds of instructions are there, those rules are there, that is called as the principles of management. Okay, these days business has assumed wider dimensions, as a result of which numerous problems arise in day-to-day activities of the manager of the enterprise has to solve these problems. A manager needs guidelines to grapple with the problems and run the organization efficiently. The principles of management guide the manager. Before entering into a detailed discussion about the principles of management, it is necessary to know the meaning of principle. Different scholars have defined principle in the following manner. So we know, see, like the business in this modern world has become so much broad or wider. Okay, so the scope of the business has become increased so much wider, and you know, there are so many number of companies. If you take any number of product, you can find at least 5 to 10 companies will be there. If you take a biscuit, there are so many biscuit manufacturing companies. If you take a mobile phone, there are so many mobile phone companies are there. Even if you take any type of product, even see like just a small, like safety pin or any small product is there. So even in that also, there are so many companies, those who are producing. So competition level has been increased, business has reached to another level. Okay, so earlier business, like if when we were small, when we were very small children, at that time if you ask for a biscuit, only Parle G biscuit was available. So if you are interested, or if you like the taste or not like, you have to purchase it. And if you go to the shop and ask for biscuit, there was nobody going to the shop and saying that like a Cadbury Oreo biscuit. Nobody will go and say to the shopkeeper. They will go just to say the name of a biscuit. Give me biscuit. Okay, one packet of biscuit. They will say, then they will give Parle G biscuit. So that is the only option available. So there was no kind of competition. There was no any problems. Okay. So that was the only option available, and we had to purchase it. But now it is not the reason, or now it is not the situation. If you go to the shop, they will ask you what sort of biscuit. If you ask for a biscuit, then they will say that what type of biscuit you want. They will say like you want to have cream biscuit, or you, in that also there are different flavors are there. Like if you say like which company's biscuit is there. And in that company also, like if you say like a Parle biscuit or a Britannia biscuit. So then the Britannia also, there are so many brands are there. So many particular products are there. In that a cream biscuit is there, or a namkeen biscuit is there. So different varieties are available, and we get it. And different companies are there. So almost similar products are there. Some products we will find that it is a copy of the other biscuit or other product. You know. So you will find a plenty of options are there. But nowadays, earlier this was not there, and it was easy for management of the business. But now it became so much complicated. Okay, so that is why there are some rules and regulations required for managing the organizations. And before we study about what is principles of management, first we have to study what is a principle. And different scholars have given different explanation about the principles. So let us discuss what are the different definitions given by different scholars. According to G.R. Terry, principle is a fundamental statement of truth, providing a guide
to the thought or action. So, as per the G.R. Terry, principle is a fundamental statement of truth, providing a guide to the thought or action. So, it is a fundamental guideline. So, it is providing a fundamental statement of truth. It is the true statement, or it is a fundamental. There is no any chance of change. So, such kind of a very definite or clear-cut rule is there. Okay, and it will provide us the guidelines to a thought or a action. So, when we are thinking about something, when we are planning about something, it will give us a guideline how it has to be there. Okay, or any action has to be performed, then it will give clear evidence or clear guideline to us that how we have to do this action. So, that kind of statements are called as principles. According to Edwin B. Flippo, a principle is a fundamental truth and it is generally stated in the form of cause and effect relationship. Okay, so another definition given by Edwin B. Flippo. So, he says that principle is a fundamental truth. It is generally stated in the form of cause and effect relationship. So, there is like everything has got a cause and effect relationship. Okay, so for an action, there is a cause. Okay, so see, like if you are eating, why you are eating? Because you are feeling hungry, and when you eat, then you will start growing, you will get energy. So, there is a cause and there is a effect. Okay, whatever, like if we imagine that, see, like if a coronavirus is there, so it has also a cause. The virus is the cause and it will affect us, and after that, there will be like fever will be there will be breathing problem will be there. So, the side effects are there. So, these are the effects. There is a cause and there is a effect. Okay. So, for anything, every kind of activities are there, for that there is a cause and a effect is there. Okay. So, we have to understand anything that we are saying. So, a fundamental principle also will explain that what is the cause and what is the effect. The cause-effect relationship, it explains the cause-effect relationship. Just like imagine that there is a ball, and if the ball is kept on the table, so if you push, what will happen? It will roll. Okay, or there is a, so there is a cause and an effect. Okay, so a push can move the property, or if like if there is a like a car is there and it is just lying down, if you give a push, if it is in the neuter and if you give a push, then it will move. Okay, so there is a cause and there is a effect. So this effect, so if you push from back, it will go forward. So that is the direction. So which there is also a direction. If you push forward, it is not going to come back. Okay, so there are some cars are there, some toy cars are there. If you push backward, it will go forward. Okay, so the cause is push back and the effect is it goes forward. So it is another type of cars are there which is running on remote. So there is a button is there, and when you press the button, it will go forward. So there is a cause and the effect. For every action that we are doing, there is a cause effect relationship is there, and this principles of management explains this cause and effect relationship. Okay, so like if there is a man, and imagine that, like if you are giving punishment to a man, so there will be the after effect will be there. So if a person is not doing the work properly, you give him punishment, next day onwards he will be doing the work properly. So, or another way is that just like giving him incentive. Okay, so imagine that if an employee is there, he is producing 8 output, and normally a person is able to do 10 output. So if you tell him that if you complete 10 output, we will give you a extra 100 rupees extra will be given. Normally like 500 rupees is paid to him and he is producing 8 output. And if you tell him that if you complete 10 output, we will give you 600 rupees. So, what will happen? This employee will be motivated to perform this task and he will do this. So, there is a cause and a effect. So, that relationship is explained in this principle. Okay. Then, next we have to study is about the Kuntz and O'Donnell. According to Kuntz and O'Donnell, management principles are fundamental truth of general validity which have value in presiding the result of management action. Okay, so here in the first two statements are the first two definitions are clearly saying the definition about the only about the principle. What is a principle doing, or what is the meaning of a principle? Okay, and the Kuntz and O'Donnell clearly explains what is a management principle. In management, we are having principles, and how these principles can be explained, or how these principles are working. Okay, so he says that Manner and principles are fundamental truth of general validity which have value in predicting the result of management action. So it has a first one, there are two specific things given there. So management principles are a fundamental truth that we have already studied. All the principles are of fundamental truth. But of general validity, it has got a general validity, means that it can be applied in any way. Okay, it can be generally applied. General validity is the first speciality, which have value in predicting the result of management action. So it has a capacity to predict the result of management. So when you do the management in this way, what will be the result of that? Okay, so the management action, when you do a management action, what will be the result of that? So it clearly explains that. That is the management principle. So the management principle, if you follow this management principle, this will be the effect of this. So we can say that it is also a cost-effect relationship. So if you do this one, what will be the result? Okay, what benefit you are going to gain? So that is what the principle is explaining. So the management principles are the fundamental truths which can be applied generally. It has got general validity as well as it explains the result of the management action. So what would be the result of a management action? That is what explains. Okay, so the definitions of these scholars show that principles are in the form of that basic truth which explains the relationship between cause and effect, and experts play an important role in their preparation. So these are the principles which are followed. They are the basic truth. Okay, so this can be called as a basic truth or a general truth. So it is always truth, true statements. Okay, so we cannot say that it is a false statements. Anybody has not simply made it. It will be always true statements, clear statements are there. And they will explain the cause and effect relationship. Okay, so what cause will be there and what result will be there. So if you do this one, what will be there? So like if the teachers are giving you, teachers are telling you that if you study nicely, you will get a good result. You will get say 70%, 80%, 90% mark. Okay, so what is the cause? The study, the effort, the hard work that you are giving in, and the result is the actual result that you are going to gain. Okay, so such a way this is there. So whatever may be the action that we are performing, whatever you do, the for an action there is a result. So such a way it has been explained. Okay, so these are about the principles of management. So this is just introduction about the principles of management. Next, we have to study the features or nature of principles of management, and that topic we will study in the coming next class. Okay, so you just have to understand about what is principles and what is a management principle. So far we have discussed about what is a principle. Okay, thank you so much.